Let's see how Minimax M2's pricing stacks up against Anthropic, GLM, DeepSeek, and Qwen. So right now you can see that it's free, obviously. But input tokens, looking at 30 cents, output tokens, $1.20, as compared to Sonnet 4.5, that's a significant difference, as we already assumed. So it looks like it's even coming in cheaper than GLM. But the difference from GLM is their coding plans. Their coding plans are extremely affordable. I know I've taken advantage of their coding plan myself, because they're basically giving half off on your first month, quarter, or year. I actually did the quarter because the value was just too good to ignore. So if you're looking at API costs, it looks like it's coming in cheaper than GLM. But if you're going with GLM's coding plans, I think GLM's going to come in way cheaper. So it will be interesting to see if Minimax M2 is going to come up with a plan. And you can see how it also compares to DeepSeek. Pretty similar pricing to DeepSeek, and then the Qwen models as well. So let's get this installed. So the Claude Code Multi-Provider Setup and Switcher Guide, which is available at my website, mediadatafusion.com, under Resources Guides. This will show you how you can install Minimax M2, but you can also install other providers. So you can also switch between the native Anthropic. You can install GLM, Minimax, that's what I said, Kimi K2, Qwen, and DeepSeek. And then we have an alternative way that you can switch between models. All this is provided in the guide. So on this machine, I only have ZAI installed in my Claude Code, but I'm going to add in the Anthropic, and we're going to add in Minimax. We'll see if I'm going to add. I might go ahead and add Kimi K2, and I might add DeepSeek. I work between multiple machines, so we can do a fresh install for this video.